So click click, call this meeting to order. It's 9:02 by my clock. So aloha mai kakou. Good morning, everyone. This is the August 22nd, 2024 Land Use Commission meeting. This is a hybrid meeting which is physically located at the Leliopapa a Kamehameha State Office Tower, 235 South Baratania Street, 406 Honolulu, Hawaii 96813, and this meeting is open to the general public. Court reporting transcriptions are also being done from this Zoom recording of this meeting. For all meeting participants, I would like to stress the importance of speaking slowly, clearly, and directly into your microphone. Before speaking, please state your name and identify yourself for the record. And that last is very important since this is a Zoom meeting and it's difficult to tell who might be speaking for some participants. This is a hybrid meeting. Please be aware that all meeting participants are being recorded on the digital record of this Zoom meeting, which will be posted to YouTube and used for court reporting purposes. Your continued participation is your implied consent to be part of the public record of this event. If you do not wish to be part of the public record, you should exit the meeting now. Also, please note that due to matters entirely outside of our control for occasional disruptions or to connectivity that may occur and for one or more members of the meeting at any given time. If such disruptions occur, please be patient as we try to restore the audiovisual signals to effectively conduct our business. Excuse me. Please note that the Q&A feature on Zoom will only be monitored for signing up public testimony. All other communications will not be addressed or part of the meeting record. Communications can be emailed to our office at dbedt.luc.web@hawaii.gov. I will also share with all participants that we are taking breaks from time to time if necessary, normally a 5 to 10 minute break every hour or so. So my name is Dan Giovanni, and I have the pleasure to serve as the LUC chair, and we currently have 9 seated commissioners. Along with me present today are Commissioner Mel Kahele, Commissioner Brian Lee from Oahu, Commissioner Uu from Maui, Commissioner Carr Smith from Kona of Hawaii Island, and Commissioner Miles Miyasoto from Hilo of Hawaii Island. Excused from today's meeting are Commissioner Kamakea Ohelo, Commissioner Hayashida, and Commissioner Yamane. Also in attendance are LUC Executive Officer Daniel Orendanker, LUC Chief Planner Scott Derrickson, LUC Staff Planner Martina Segura, LUC Chief Clerk Ariana Kwan, and LUC Attorney General. I believe that is Miranda Steed. Can that be confirmed for me?
Yes, Chair. This is Deputy Attorney General Miranda Steed.
Thank you for joining us today. Okay, our next order of business is the adoption of order for SP09-403, Department of Environmental Services, Waimanala Gulch Sanitary Landfill. This agenda item is to adopt the order granting the 2024 motion to amend. Condition number one of the Planning Commission's finding of fact, conclusions of law, and decisions of order dated June 10th, 2019. And condition number five of the 2019 LUC finding of fact, conclusions of law, and decisions of order. At this time, I'd like the parties to identify themselves, beginning with the petitioner.
Jeffrey Hu, good morning. This is Deputy Corporation Counsel Jeffrey Hu, along with Camila Chan. We're for the City and County of Honolulu's Department of Environmental Services.
Thank you, Mr. Hu. Is the intervener Ko'olina Community Association represented?
Yes, Chair. Good morning. Calchip Chase and Chris Gooden joining remotely for Ko'olina Community Association and Senator Miley Shimabukuro.
Thank you. Is intervener Schnitzer present, and who represents him?
Yes, Chair. This is Joyce Tam Sugiyama and Rui Yuan for Schnitzer.
Thank you. For the county, city and county of Honolulu, who is present, please, and representing?
Aloha mai kakou. Pono Arias, Deputy Corporation Counsel on behalf of the Department of Planning and Permitting.
Thank you very much. And for the State Office of Planning and Sustainable Development, who is present and representing?
Good morning. Allison Kato, Deputy Attorney General for the Office of Planning and Sustainable Development. And Katia Balasiano from OPSD is also here. Thank you.
Great. Thank you for joining us. So our reimbursement policy. Good morning, Mr. Hu. Have you reviewed HAR 15-15-45.1 regarding the reimbursement of hearing expenses?
Jeffrey Hu, I reviewed it last time. I haven't reviewed it since.
Okay, so you still, go ahead.
Sorry, but yes, I'm still aware of the HAR rule.
Okay, and you agree?
Jeffrey Hu, yes.
Thank you very much. So disclosures and conflicts of interest in accordance with HRS section 84-14, commissioners are not allowed to take any official action affecting a business in which they or a member of their family have a financial interest. They must therefore recuse themselves from this matter if there is any benefit, monetary or otherwise, to themselves or members of their family. Also, in accordance with legal ethical standards, the commissioners should disclose any relationship, business, social or otherwise, that they may have with the petitioner or its representatives or any of the other parties in this proceeding that may give rise to an allegation of bias or impropriety. Do any of the commissioners present today have any conflicts of interest or disclosures to make at this time? So I can't see the room clearly one by one. So Ms. Kwan, can you verify that there is no commissioner that is asking to speak up at this time?
No, Mr. Chair, nobody is trying to speak up.
Okay, great. So there are no conflicts of interest or disclosures to make, and we will proceed. So let me briefly explain the procedure for today. First, I will recognize the written public testimony that has been submitted in this matter. Next, I will call for members of the public who wish to provide oral testimony on this matter. After completion of the public testimony portion of the proceedings, the chair would like to ask the parties if they had any comments on the adoption of order. At the conclusion of the parties' comments and commissioners' questions, the public will again be granted a second opportunity to provide public testimony in the manner set forth previously. Finally, the commission will conduct its deliberations. Please be informed that the relevant records and documents pertaining to this matter can be accessed for review on the LUC website, and I'm going to say this twice, https://luc.hawaii.gov/sp09-403. Again, https://luc.hawaii.gov/sp09-403. I will now recognize written public testimony that has been submitted in this matter. Ms. Kwan, has there been any written testimony submitted on this matter?
No new testimony has been submitted, Chair.
Thank you, Ms. Kwan. Are there any members of the public who wish to testify on this matter? Ms. Kwan, has anybody signed up or indicated through Zoom that they wish to testify?
Nobody has indicated in the Q&A feature that they would like to testify.
Thank you. We'll proceed then. Mr. Hu, please make your comments, your presentation.
Jeffrey Hu. Chair, I have no further comments since our presentation from 2 weeks ago. Thank you.
So the question on the question has to do with the adoption of order. So you are suggesting that you have no comments relative to the adoption of the order. Is that correct?
Jeffrey Hu, yes, that's correct. except that, you know, we hope that the Land Use Commission continues to go forward with proceed with adopting the order as indicated in the previous meeting. Thank you.
Thank you for the clarification. Commissioners, any questions for Mr. Hu at this point? I see none. So now we'll move to the intervener, Mr. Chip Chase.
Yes, Chair, Cal Chip Chase. Chair, members, we do have one comment on the proposed order at page 68 of the proposed order, as the order is stating its conclusion. In the second to last line and the last line, the proposed order reads, with the addition of quarterly reporting from the applicant to the Land Use Commission. We would suggest that sentence should be revised to capture the quarterly reporting requirement imposed by the Honolulu Planning Commission, as well as to specify that the quarterly reporting to the Land Use Commission is in writing and not in person, which I think is clear from the commission's decision at our last meeting on this matter. So if I may propose a simple revision that captures both of those points, and as you'll recall, Chair and members, no doubt, the motion was made to approve the petition with the Planning Commission's condition of quarterly reporting plus the Land Use Commission's condition of quarterly reporting in writing. And so to capture the motion faithfully, I would ask that last clause beginning at the second line on page 68, the second to last line on page 68, be amended to read as follows. With the quarterly reporting condition imposed by the Planning Commission and further subject to quarterly reporting from the applicant to the Land Use Commission in writing. With that addition, Chair, that modification to the final clause, no further comment on the order, and accept it as presented by staff.
Thank you, Mr. Chip Chase. Commissioners, any questions for Mr. Chip Chase, including any questions or comments to his suggested change?
Chair.
Commissioner Lee.
Yeah, can Mr. Chip Chase clarify the Planning Commission in Honolulu, theirs was in person and the LUC is in writing, is that correct?
That's correct, Commissioner.
Okay, thank you, Chair. Thank you, Mr. Chip Chase.
Okay, any further questions for Mr. Chip Chase? So if the commission, just the way I understand this, if the commission would agree to that suggested amendment, we'll take it up in deliberations before we vote to adopt the order. Okay, petitioner, do you have any comment on the presentation by Mr. Chip Chase?
Jeffrey, I have no comments. Thank you.
Thank you. Intervener Schnitzer, do you have any comments on the recommendations and comments of Mr. Chip Chase?
Joyce Tam Sugiyama, we have no objections to what Mr. Chip Chase proposed.
Very good. The county, do you have any comment or on Mr. Chip Chase's testimony or and recommendation?
Aloha, Pono Arias. No objections to Mr. Chip Chase's recommendations.
Thank you. OPSD, your turn.
Allison Kato, we're fine with that too. Thank you.
Very good. Commissioners, any final comments or questions for Mr. Chip Chase? Okay, hearing
none. I got a question. Chair, I got a question.
Who's that? Commissioner Kahele.
Mel Kahele, yes.
You are right.
Yes, thank you. I know, Mr. Hu, I know there was a lot of questions asked in our last meeting, but that I think what was unanswered is we've granted you 2 years extension, find a new location. is that new location is going to include the waste that's currently being dumped, the construction demolition waste that's currently being dumped at PVT, considering they only got 7 years of life left? I guess that was a question I believe someone may have asked that wasn't answered.
So, Mr. Commissioner Cahill, to whom are you directing your question?
Mr. Hu.
Jeffrey Hu. So, I believe the 7 years that we were talking about is in regard to, or it was more like 7.5 to 8 years, was in regard to the Waimalolo Gulch. The PVT landfill currently, we're not sure exactly when it's going to close, but I thought the capacity was probably less than that currently. But to answer your question, the new landfill that we're looking to identify and eventually site, that's currently going to be a municipal, it's going to take in municipal waste. And so if the PVT landfill closes, and PVT, just for everybody's information, takes in construction and demolition waste. And so if that closes, and if there is no other C&D waste landfill out there, then I guess the city would have to look into whether it has to take in C&D as waste as well. But currently we're, I believe that, you know, the new landfill that we're trying to identify, currently we're only looking at MSW, which is municipal solid waste.
So what's going to happen with the construction demolition waste once PVT shuts down? Isn't the city responsible for all of the waste that flows through the county or Honolulu?
Jeffrey, I think you're right, because the city is probably the last, you know, it's the city's duty, right, to the people to figure out what to do. So I think if the city is faced with that issue, then I think it's up to the city to figure out where to put that C&D waste. So you're correct, I think.
So wouldn't you want to look for a location that's going to include the construction demolition? Because currently, Waimalolo Gulch is able to take construction demolition.
That's...
Yes.
Jeffrey, who...
So the new location that you're possibly going to be looking at finding within the next 6 months, the permit will also include construction or just MSW?
Jeffrey, who, I believe you're right that it would probably include both C&D and MSW. Yes. So
Mr. Babcock's in attendance.
So that Jeffrey, who, I don't think he's in attendance today.
Okay. All right. So the answer is yes.
Jeffrey, who, you know, I think it's going to be a yes. It's just that I don't know where the next site is, so I'm kind of just speculating.
Okay, we'll take it as that. Thank you. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Commissioner. Thank you, Mr. Hu. So where was I? Intervenor Schnitzer, you have a presentation?
Joyce Tam Sugiyama, we have nothing further to add. Thank you.
So... Do you suggest or recommending adoption of the order?
Yes, with Mr. Chip Chase's recommended modification.
Thank you very much. Commissioners, any questions for Ms. Sukiyama? Petitioner, any questions for Ms. Sukiyama? Mr. Hu, any questions?
I'm so sorry. Jeffrey Hu, no questions, no comments. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Chip Chase, any questions?
Al Chip Chase, no questions, Chair.
Thank you. City and County, any questions?
Pono Arias, no questions or comments.
Thank you. OPSD, any questions?
Allison Cotton, no questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Commissioners, final round. Any comments or questions for City and County of Honolulu? Okay, thank you. So, City and County of Honolulu, would you like to present your position on the adoption of the order? It's Mr. Urias.
Hi, Paul Arias. No objections as to form. We would approve of adopting.
Thank you very much. Commissioners, any questions for City and County of Honolulu? Mr. Chip Chase, any questions for City and County of Honolulu?
Cal Chip Chase, no questions, Chair.
Thank you. Ms. Sukuyama, any questions for City and County?
No questions.
OPSD, any questions for City and County?
Allison Kato, no questions.
Thank you. Last round, commissioners, any final comments or questions for City and County? Okay. So now we're up to OPSD for their final presentation of their position relative to adoption of the order.
Allison Kato, OPSD is fine with adoption of this order with Mr. Chip Chase's revision. And the only thing I want to note is a typo on page 56, paragraph 343. My name has one L. And on page 19, I'm not sure if there's maybe a word that's highlighted. That's all the comments I have. Thank you.
What was the last comment about the highlighting? What page was that?
Page 19. I think there's a word that's highlighted, or at least it is in my printout.
Okay. Thank you. Commissioners, any questions for OPSD? Petitioner, Mr. Hu, any questions for OPSD?
Jeffrey Hu, no questions. Thank you.
Mr. Chip Chase, any questions or comments for OPSD?
Cal Chip Chase, no questions or comments, Chair.
Thank you. Mr. Schnitzer, Ms. Sukuyama, any questions?
Joyce Tam Sugiyama, no questions or comments.
Okay, commissioners, final chance, any questions, comments? Very good. So typo on page 56 and a highlight on page 19. So we'll clean that up. The staff will clean that up, verify and clean that up, obviously. So at this time, the commission will now consider adoption of the order by its public deliberations. Commissioners, before you and for your consideration is a deliberation and adoption of the proposed findings of fact, conclusions of law, and decisions of order prepared by staff as instructed at the meeting on this, at the last meeting on this docket. So are there any questions or recommendations or motions at this time? And let me invite a motion that would include the non-controversial recommendations made today.
Ms. Kwan, I think you forgot to offer a second round of testimony before deliberations.
Oh, to the public?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't see that. Thank you so much. Is there anyone signed up to do public testimony at this time?
If anyone in the public would like to give a testimony, please use the Q&A feature now. Seeing none, Chair.
So we may proceed now?
Yes, you may.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Kwan, for that. I really appreciate it. I'm sorry I overlooked it. Okay, what I was saying is the chair will entertain a motion, and I'm going to call on Commissioner Lee in just a second. And Mr. Lee, let me encourage you to either include or not include considerations of the recommendations that were made by the interveners. So Mr. Lee, you are recognized.
Thank you, Chair. I move to adopt the proposed findings of fact, conclusions of law, and decision in an order for the application to modify SP09-403, SUP number 2008, SUP-2, in accordance with the comments made by Mr. Chip Chase and with the conditions of the Honolulu Planning Commission to include quarterly in-person meetings and in writing updates quarterly to the Land Use Commission.
Thank you. And you would also, I assume you'd also advise to correct the typo and the highlight if that in fact is the case.
That is correct, to correct the two typographical errors, the highlighting and the misspelling of Ms. Kato's name in the proposed draft. Thank you.
Mr. Orendaker, is that your hand up?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Staff would request that the order include authorization for the chair to sign the order.
Mr. Lee, would your motion include an authorization for the chair to sign the order?
Isn't that standard procedure? Or are you trying to differentiate between everyone signing and just the chair signing, to clarify?
Commissioner Lee, it is standard procedure, but it also is a good idea to make it clear that the chair is authorized to sign the modified order.
All right, I'll amend my motion to include authorizing the chair to sign on behalf of the Land Use Commission.
Okay, so do I have a second to the motion made by Commissioner Lee? Let me restate the Commissioner Carr-Smith, can you restate the motion that you provide a second for?
Approval subject to Mr. Chip Chase's recommendation and Ms. Cotto's notations on typos and executive officer's inclusion of the chair having the ability to sign on the LUC's behalf.
Very good. Thank you very much. Commissioners, any comments anybody wants to make in support or in opposition of the motion, starting with Commissioner Lee?
None, Chair.
Thank you. Commissioner Carr-Smith?
Nothing more here. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other commissioners? The chair will support the motion as presented by Commissioner Lee and seconded by Commissioner Carr-Smith. Mr. Orendanker, please poll the commissioners for a vote.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The motion is to adopt the findings of fact and conclusions of law in accordance with the comments made by petitioner and corrections or typographical errors and authorization of the chair to sign the motion on LUC's behalf.
Mr. Orendanker, I think the suggestion was by the intervener, not the petitioner.
Oh, I'm sorry, the intervener. My bad, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so start over.
The motion is to adopt findings of fact and conclusions of law in accordance with the comments made by intervener and correction of typographical errors and authorization of the chair to sign the motion on LUC's on the LUC's behalf.
Shouldn't that include decisions in order too? You mentioned findings of fact, conclusions of law, but you and twice did not include decision in order. Thank you.
Okay,
let's start over.
Move to adopt the findings of fact, conclusions of law, and decision in order in accordance with the comments made by intervener and corrections of typographical errors and authorization of the chair to sign the order on LUC's behalf.
Okay, proceed.
Commissioner Lee.
Aye.
Commissioner Carr-Smith.
Aye.
Commissioner Hayashida is excused. Commissioner Kahele.
Aye.
Commissioner Kamake Ohello is excused. Commissioner Miyasato.
Aye.
Commissioner Uu.
Aye.
Commissioner Yamane is excused. Chair Giovanni.
Aye.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The motion passes unanimously with 6 votes.
Very good. Thank you. So this concludes our meeting for today, unless there's any further business to discuss. Commissioners, anything at this point? Hearing none, the meeting is adjourned. Thank you very much for your time this morning. Appreciate it.